G'day, I'm Nick McArdle, and thanks for joining me once again for another episode of Reds TV. After 3 weeks of playing the best New Zealand sides, this week the Reds will be keen to grab as many points as possible when they take on the Lions at Suncorp Stadium. Bonus points have been pretty hard to come by for the Super Rugby champions this season. However, this week is certainly a great opportunity to collect everything on offer against the South African visitors. The Reds are tracking for another solid Saturday night crowd this weekend, and no doubt the Reds army will again be there in numbers, wearing red and driving their team home. Now, let's go back and check out what a Reds insider made of how their side performed against the Chiefs last weekend.
The Reds ran out against the Chiefs, keen to inflict some damage on the New Zealanders after a close loss to the Crusaders the week before. The boys' efforts paid off, taking down the table-topping Waikato side 42 points to 27. The win was the Reds' first bonus point victory of the season, scoring an impressive 5 tries. Reds TV caught up with Reds attack coach Jim Mackay to gain an exclusive insight into how important the win against the Chiefs was to their season.
In the context of the competition, it was critical, so we obviously needed the points, but also, you know, if we're serious about what we're doing, where we're at, and, you know, we needed to beat them. We're hunting the teams above us, so it was very critical to score 5 tries against, and conversely, they hadn't conceded 4 tries either. So overall, it was a fantastic game, I thought. Both sides played really well. To score the 4 tries was really important, give us an extra point. And it was really pleasing how we scored them. So, you know, we've got our base game, which we believe in. But in the Australian way and the Reds way, you've got to be innovative. So we identified a few areas for that specific game, and it was really pleasing that they came off and it worked for us. The defence reflects the spirit of the team. So how hard they're going to defend our lines, you know, critical. So again, Matt Taylor, he identified some areas where they'd be kicking and going near our line. We knew it would be coming. So we knew when it comes, we've got to stand up to that. And, you know, that was really pleasing. Stuff like restarts, lineouts. I mean, there was one restart where we kicked it short and got it, and we picked and goes for 45 metres up the left-hand sideline. You don't see that very much. I can't remember the last time I saw something like that, so that was a terrific effort from the forwards. And then what else helped us as well in the Chiefs game was their goal kicking. So we started off the season well, and then we dipped down to 50%, and then on the weekend it was 85%.
Probably Toto Kefu or George Smith. I just love the way they played, and you know, they were just so dominant in what they did, and you know, great players.
Toto Kefu! Did he get it? That is the match winner!
I can't remember, to tell you the truth, but probably. And it sort of just kept wearing it, but I've recently got rid of it, so. I did when I was a bit younger. Always played basketball from a young age, and just sort of basketball, rugby each weekend, and I don't know, I ended up choosing rugby.
To help celebrate Mother's Day, members of the St George Queensland Reds were keen to spoil their mums with something a little bit different this year. Thanks to St George Bank, James Horwell, Ben Lucas, Liam Gill and Eddie Quirk were given the opportunity to team up with top chef Alistair McLeod at Brisbane's Tank Restaurant and cook up a storm. Armed with top information fresh out of St George's special Mother's Day survey, the players knew they were kicking goals by spending time with their mums and choosing to make their gifts rather than buying something expensive. Reds TV weren't going to miss out on this one. Let's see what the boys managed to plate up for their proud mums.
It's certainly about the sentimental values, and we are here today doing a nice thing for our mum. It's certainly not an arena I back myself in or spend much time in, but being able to cook and seeing kind of the happiness that even if they are laughing at us, that it brings our mothers, it's good fun.
James is our leader, but I'm not sure if we led in the kitchen. How did this performance go?
Excellent.
I couldn't fault it. That's presentation
exceptional.
Yeah.
Mrs. Clerk, he entertained us.
Did he?
But didn't pull through.
He did.
I believe that his pancake got sabotaged someplace for some people in the kitchen.
This is my
chef's done that. Well, thank you. I hope you enjoyed it.
Great job, gentlemen. Fantastic. The last one to finish does the washing up.
In association with the Sony Centre, Reds TV are happy to announce the winner of the first Reds Member of the Week prize pack. Congratulations to Luke Murphy of Brisbane City. You're the winner of a Sony 3D Blu-ray home theatre system valued at $799. We'll be in contact with you on how to collect your prize from the Sony Centre Brisbane. Tune in next week to see if you're our lucky winner.
Round 3 of the Queensland Premier Rugby competition saw some cracking matches contested across southeast Queensland. Brothers travelled to Shaw Sports where they met Norths. The boys from Crosby proved too strong in the end, taking the game 36 points to 10, including a hat-trick to flanker Charlie Freeney. Souths were looking to get back into the winner's circle when they hosted Uni at Chipsywood Oval. After getting off to a strong start, University let Souths back in the game courtesy of three quick tries. A high-scoring affair saw Uni eventually walk away with the chocolates, taking the game 33 points to 22. The match of the round saw Sunnybank play host to Jeeps at Old Mac Oval. The Dragons started well, scoring the first try. But Jeeps soon replied with their own five-pointer, coming off the back of a strong run by flanker Moggy Way. In the end, Sunnybank couldn't build on their 13-10 half-time lead, succumbing to the young Gallopers side 22 points to 18. East travelled north to Stockland Park to play the Stingrays, who were looking for their first win of the year. The Tigers started well with two long-range tries, but the Sunshine Coast hit back with two tries of their own. East proved to be too strong in the end, finishing the game with five tries in the 46-20 victory. A strong performance against the Dragons on their home turf saw this week's Musashi High Performer Award go to Jeeps number 7, Moggy Way. Congratulations, Moggy. I'm sure that Musashi prize pack will be put to good use. For the third week in a row, Jeeps will feature in this week's Match of the Round as they play host to University at Yoku Road. With both teams coming into the game undefeated, this match is sure to live up to expectation. Stay tuned next week for more Premier Rugby action. Well, South Africa's perennial cellar dwellers, the Lions, weren't given much of a chance ahead of this year's Super Rugby season, but recent performances have shown John Mitchell's squad certainly do have the ability to push plenty of sides right to the limit. Let's check all the action from the last time the Reds and the Lions met. And those of you going to the game, make sure you cheer our Queensland boys home and pass the four try bonus point.
The Reds were on a roll when they made the trip to the Republic last year. And first stop of their South African tour were the Lions in Johannesburg. Heading in as favourites to pick up their fifth win of the season, the Reds hit an early setback when James Slipper and then captain James Hall were shown yellow cards during the first half. Despite being down to 14 men for most of the opening 40 minutes, the backline kept firing, with winger Luke Morihan slicing through to score the Reds' first try. Mike Harris and his reliable boot made the conversion, and he kept the Reds in touch on the scoreboard with a number of penalties. After setting Morihan up for his first try, Wade Cooper came back into the action to score one of his own, courtesy of some great footwork and pace. But winger Digby Ioane gave the Reds the last say, charging through to ice a 30-25 victory. This weekend, the Reds will look to take the next step in their return to top form, and they will be confident of another strong display in front of their home crowd at Suncorp Stadium.
When greatness calls, we will respond.
Thanks again for joining me for another episode of Reds TV. Tickets are still available to the Lions match, so if you're in Brisbane, why not get along to the game at Suncorp Stadium? Visit Ticketek for more information. It's your last chance to see the Reds in action as Super Rugby takes a break in the June internationals. Tune in next week for more exclusive behind the scenes action. And don't forget, Twitter fans, send in your questions to @Reds_rugby or your feedback to rugby@qru.com.au. We'd love to hear from you. Best of luck to the Reds this weekend. I'm Nick McArdle. Enjoy the week. We'll see you next weekend.